So I wanted to give you a quick little review on this week's lesson of drawing from observation as a very effective warm-up. We can start with blind contour, where I'm not looking at my paper while I draw, but I'm only studying the actual object. And in doing so, I attempt to experience it in three dimension. And I, even though I might not touch it, I'm getting a sense of how the form changes in direction, width, all the little details. I'm feeling it as if I can touch it with two hands. I feel the different forms, the size, the texture, utilizing all of my senses to capture its likeness. And this is what I came up with first. Then I did a observational sketch of estimating the height and the width. So given the exact parameter of where the object stops, if I were to draw a straight line up here, then over here, straight down, and then across. And that can include the shadow. So it, from my angle, it took up, I would say, almost 2x as tall as it is wide in this given space that it's taking up. If I changed the direction and made it more vertical, it would be more narrow compared to the height. Then as I proceed through the sketch proportion, then I move into value and detail. I again utilize my sense of sculpting, and I see that this in fact has some divisions, some little angular components that shift in direction and get narrower up here. And then this has, if I squint my eyes, I see how much darker this is, which will begin to show three dimension. It's lighter underneath, then it's much darker. I'm exaggerating that to make it look like it's going back, and so on. So I want to balance almost like vertical and horizontal, or even diagonal, the shadow values, the form, not just filling in straight, but always follow the contours. So we know that it's going vertical and a diagonal, but it's the coming towards us, the contour lines, that will actually make it the most three-dimensional. So let's continue with that. And then always notice where the light is coming. It's lighter on this side, and you can see that up here where these little shapes at the top are darker. And then you see more detail, and then here it's less light on dark, then it's halfway in here, then here is more light than dark. This goes in more, angles more, and then this, these wonderful little details here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there we go. Okay, what else? This, sometimes we really have to make a decision between patterns on the surface and the light and dark highlight and shadow shapes. Squinting your eyes will help. And that's a observational drawing, blind contour. And now you try.